evaluating a potential property to buy in this week's Purchase or Pass. Now, in our Purchase or Pass segment this week, we take a look at some of the issues that may be hidden under the surface. It's a two-bed, one-bath, single-level terrace that has been recently renovated, and so there's nothing that needs to be done except move in. It's well located to the local cafes and restaurants, as well as a local hospital. There are polished floorboards throughout, and it features a combined living and dining area. At the rear, there's a leafy courtyard with paved area and pedestrian access from the rear lane. Now, from the reports I read about this property, Charles, it was reported that the agent was asking quite a high price, and this was the first thing that put off quite a few buyers to start with. So I guess the first question for you is how important is it for both the vendor and the agent to price it right? Because you don't want to underprice it or overprice it.
Well, a really difficult situation there, because there are four prices you can put on a property. There's a price the owner wants for it, there's a price an agent thinks it might sell for, there's a price a purchaser will pay for it, and then there's another price that a valuer will put on it. So there's always four different prices. And if you put a price in too high, yes, you're certainly going to turn a lot of people off who think maybe that's just outside of my price range. But if you put the price too low and it sells for higher, then the Office of Fair Trading are going to come and talk to you.
And everyone screams and says, oh...
That's right, underquoting. So it's very, very difficult to place a price on it. And now you're seeing properties that are selling for way in excess of reserve, and now the Office of Fair Trading are saying, well, gee, maybe the agent's underquoting again. But it's really what's going on in the marketplace that's causing this discrepancy at the moment.
It really is tough, because say someone wants kind of 700 for the property and they're quoting 650 plus, there is a real chance that if no one's buying it at 700 and the vendor will take 650 on a worst day, then it could. So you don't want to exclude all those buyers if there is still a 10% chance that it might not sell on the day at 700.
Some of the best auctions that I did when I was auctioning were the ones I did for Department of Main Roads or government departments. They never told you a reserve. I would stand there, literally be standing there at the lectern, and halfway through an auction I would have a representative walk up and hand me an envelope, and it was at that point in time I knew what the reserve price was. So there was working between the agent and the client, but still even they kept the complete total reserve concept out of anybody's eyes. And agents cop flack for that, because people will ask them the question and they can't answer the question.
And they cop flack for anything they say anyway. The second issue that came up in here was, it was also reported that supposedly there was termites in the wall by the bathroom that apparently maybe covered up, and then suddenly they were found out afterwards. So again, is once that reputation gets around, then that puts out a lot of the buyers as well.
Yeah, look, that when generally come up at an inspection, you see that happen a lot, particularly, and a lot of people get turned off by that. But most of the transactions go through when they find termites, because some of the owners will agree to pay for it, and then they get that fixed and they move on. I've seen that happen quite a bit.
And that's what actually happened in this one. So the final purchaser managed to negotiate a lower price than they were talking about, but also it was a full termite treatment for the next 6 months, and I think a margin for rent as well, that they wouldn't get rent during that time. So that's why I thought I'd feature this one. I thought it was really good for the purchaser to actually negotiate that plan.
Yeah, look, I have seen it happen. I've seen it happen firsthand, and some owners will, okay, they agree to it, take the property off the market for a period of time, get the work rectified, and then they're back on again. So it can happen.
So certainly for the things like the termites and stuff like that, purchase or pass for you?
This particular one, so I've purchased this one because I like its location, I like the look of it, and it's very hard in the area that it's in. I know which area it's in, to buy property. That's one of the main reasons.
And look, for me, based on the information we have, I think it's a great example of property negotiation based on the facts that often scares the majority of other buyers. So if everyone else is scared, potentially there's an opportunity. So if the property details and location suited the buyer, then I'd say this is a purchase.